Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And today I've got something a bit different for you. This is actually a 1973 Mercury Montego MX. And these are pretty rare cars. In fact, I can't even recall the last time I saw one in person. And this is an extremely nice example, so I thought we'd take a look at it here. You can see it's got the nice chrome bumper up front, as well as the quad headlamps. Then you have this nice chrome grille right here in the center with a Mercury script badge right on the front corner here. And it definitely grabs your attention in that yellow. And they spent, they said over $20,000 doing a restoration on it. So it's in pretty top-notch shape. It's riding on some Magnum 500 wheels. These are reproductions, not the factory originals. But they definitely look great on this car. With some B.F. Goodrich white letter tires. And you got your Montego MX badges right here on the fender. The Montego is actually named after Montego Bay in Jamaica. If I'm saying that right, it might be Montego, don't know. All the glass and trim is looking good on it. Nice chrome mirrors on both sides. And it does have a black vinyl top. And that's looking like new. I mean, this thing is really in excellent condition. Here, we'll take a peek inside. All black vinyl interior. Just manual windows. And you got your mirror control right there. The seats are still looking like new. It's got the 50-50 split back bench seat with headrests. Of course, rear seat to match. But it's just in beautiful condition. Even the dashboard's nice and smooth, no cracking or anything. All factory original in here, as far as the steering wheel and gauge package. It does have a factory tachometer. Still has the factory AM/FM radio. I mean, it's in pretty amazing condition. Here, we'll continue on out back. Once again, we have a big chrome bumper at the rear here with the taillights inset into it. Then another script badge over here on the edge of the deck lid. It does have a Ford 9-inch rear in it. And as you can see, it has dual exhaust with chrome tips. And probably the most important thing about this car is what's under the hood. So let's go ahead and pop it open here and we'll take a look. As you can see, it's looking really immaculate under the hood here as well. And this is actually the last year for the 351 Cleveland. This is the Q code 351 Cobra Jet. You can see right there on the air cleaner. And it looks very factory original under here. Still has the original exhaust manifolds, decals, everything. Just in really impressive condition. And like I said, 73 was the last year for the Cleveland. And the last year for any significant horsepower, really. For quite a while after that, the ratings really dropped down on American cars. But, I mean, it's just looking immaculate under here. Very nice. So, I mean, pretty cool car. I mean, nice, big, comfortable car. Plenty of room in there. They ride nice. And then you have this extremely durable drivetrain with the 351, an automatic, and a 9-inch Ford. So, I mean, it's a pretty nice package. Let's go ahead and check out the specs on it here. Once again, it's a 1973 Mercury Montego MX. Factory tack engages. Those are reproduction Magna 500s, like I said. 351 Q code, Cobra Jet. Does have new dual exhaust. And they're asking $23,950. I mean, it's hard to imagine finding one that's in better shape than this one. Just a really beautiful example. Well, anyway, guys, hopefully you found it as interesting as I did. As always, I do appreciate you watching and commenting. And if you haven't already, click subscribe, and we'll have many more videos on the way. Thanks again. Bye.